This is a pen, but it's not just like any other pen. It can write in a vacuum, underwater, and in freezing or boiling hot temperatures. It can write upside down, and even in zero gravity. But of course, if you know about this pen, it's probably not because of its impressive capabilities, but rather because of its impressive price tag. This is the story of the $1 million space pen. During the Cold War in the 1960s, the Soviets and Americans were racing to launch ever more ambitious space missions. Considered to be the last frontier, space is an inhospitable place. And needless to say, missions into space had to overcome thousands of challenges. Perhaps the most trivial one of those was coming up with a writing tool suitable for use in zero gravity. According to the story, the Soviets and Americans took very different approaches to solving this problem. But that is perhaps best summarized in this clip from an episode of The West Wing.
We spent millions of dollars developing a pen for the astronauts that would work in zero gravity. You know what the Russians did?
They used a pencil?
They used a pencil.
And there you have it. Proof that you don't need to be a rocket scientist to be a genius, right? You see, there are several major problems with this story. First of all, the pen wasn't even developed by the US government, but by a private company run by Paul Fisher. And although he reportedly spent about $1 million of his own money developing the pen, the cost per unit that NASA paid was only $6. This in turn was a significant reduction compared to the price of the mechanical pencils NASA used prior to the space pen at $128 per unit. Ironically, it was the high cost of the pencils that caused public backlash, which led to the agency looking for alternatives and eventually choosing the Fisher space pen as a replacement. Another problem with the story is that regardless of price, pencils are just not suitable for use in space. Similar to submarines, space capsules are closed environments and thus subject to strict contamination requirements. And while pencils have no problem functioning in zero gravity, the release of wood shavings, graphite dust, or broken graphite tips are a dangerous hazard. Not only could those particles get into the eyes of astronauts, potentially preventing them from operating the equipment, but they could also damage the electronics on board. But perhaps the biggest proof that the $1 million space pen story is a myth is that by 1969, the Soviets were using the same pen on board of their Soyuz space flights.